Welcome back to the disaster, which is known as the Bed of Chaos. And you'll soonly find out why I say this. But there are going to be a lot of jump cuts on this because... Bed of Chaos. The one boss that FromSoft actually apologized to the internet for. As you can see, the first mistake I made is running to the left. You should probably always go to the right. And we're just using the standard technique of shooting at a distance. Not anything really interesting going on right here. Sorry about that. We're just shooting out the branches until we can hit the glowy thing. And I'm apparently having difficulty even doing that. I decided to show this entire video logical progressions, so and this is more of a, I guess, learning guide. As you can see, there's no threat, so I actually could have probably just ran in there and hit it with a knife, but... And what we're trying to hit is that... See that glowing arm? And we hit it. That glowing arm that goes up, that's what you want to get. And that's what triggers this event to happen. And at this point, the whole fight gets a lot more ridiculous. I like how it's kind of a Cthulhu tree. Anyway, yeah. So the floor starts falling out from under you, which on this side of the map really isn't all that bad. Just walk and don't run. You'll probably be okay. But you're gonna see here in a second why you should always go to the right first. Yep, floor is totally gone. So, I tried the technique to quit out and then go back in. But this is really something you should only do if you went to the right side first. You can quit out, go back in, and then the path to the left side is actually fairly easy to get to because the floor isn't hard. You don't have to jump over anything. Having a little bit of fun surfing on the way down. But yeah, I wanted to show how bad this is for zero poise players. Yep. Just tried to avoid the hand. Jumped in a hole. That was mostly my fault. But now I'm going to show it from the Bed of Chaos's perspective. Yep. And this is why people are mad about this boss. So I figured out I needed a lot of poise, so I put the wolf ring on and Lautrec's armor. It's just what I happened to have on me when I got here. As you will see, not so bad. Except for the slow running. Very slow. And once you get here, it's basically a gimme. So that is the second part of the fight. And you're going to see some weird things because of DS Fix. And I switched to the ring here because at this point there's going to be a lot of fire. And yeah, just dead. So, thinking that, oh, Lautrec's armor is going to get me where I need to go, we have to do the middle part. I actually just kind of like this slide. It's a little ridiculous, but it's kind of fun. Yeah, so that happens. Never walk straight down the middle path here. Yeah. And just get knocked around. And then it dawned on me that I have pyromancies and there's really no reason for me to be wearing Lautrec's armor. And I have the Covenant Gold Serpent ring on because I was getting red Titanite chunks. But yeah, it dawned on me to use unexpected fire reaction to use Iron Flesh here. Zero poise plus Iron Flesh equals not getting knocked down so much. See? Pretty sweet. So yeah, this is actually what I like about Dark Souls is that you learn to play it. You learn what toolset you have and then you adapt. Now at this point, I figured I can make it with Iron Flesh again. So I put it on, I start walking, and I'm immediately destroyed by fire. So, now that we know how to get past the first part, which is Iron Flesh, we figure out the second part, which isn't Iron Flesh. Know to do that. Walk our way there like a golem. Although sometimes it's still cheap. Just a minute ago I was walking through there and now it's knocking me down. This is why they came out and apologized. It's just ridiculous. This whole fight's ridiculous. But yeah, that just bought me enough time to get down here again. And now I switched to Flash Sweat. It's not going off, but it's saving me a lot of damage. That would have normally just killed me, but Flash Sweat is still technically active. And you can roll through all this. That's the kill. I hope it helps people who messed up and went to the left first. Oops. Guess we all learned a lesson. Also, zero poise is kind of difficult, but remember what tools you have.